Hello, my name is Jan Kili, and today we are going to be looking at how easy it is to translate into PADs different databases. It is always a concern of designers moving from one software to another to be able to save their IP as schematic layout and libraries, and we will review this going forward. They are available for Altium, Designer, P-CAD, OrCAD, and CADstar. And those translates can translate either schematic, layout, and libraries as one push of a button. Let's review how easy it is to do so. And now we will translate the Altium Designer database into the PADs. We'll select the folder from our projects, and I'm going to translate the TOM.PCB file. And I will also place it output file into the same location as we were using before. So I'm going to select Altium Design to PADs, and subfolder is TR. Now I can translate the database. Of course, I can translate libraries also if I had them. So translating, again, doesn't take that long. Goes through it, extract all the information that is necessary for the PADs layout from the Altium database. It's almost done. And once it is finished, it'll give us the report. There is no errors. There's only warnings that you can review them later. So we'll close this. We'll open this translated database. It's, of course, located in the same location as we've done it before, storing it in the My Documents. And I'll pick the Altium to PADs and subfolder TR. Notice again, it has added the underscore PADs database to indicate that it was translated. And now I'm opening this database, and it's a fairly good size design. And as you can see, the translation has performed all the necessary data that needs to be translated inside the PADs. So there is components, routing, even the copper. And if we go and look at setup design rules under classes, there's even different classes that was set up inside the Altium that came in into the PADs database. So as you can see, it's easy and straightforward capability to translate these databases inside PADs. Now we will translate the P-CAD schematic into the DX Designer. So first we need to create a project. So we'll create a new project, and I'll browse to where I want to place that project. I have P-CAD DX Designer project and folder TR, and the project will be also called TR. So I'll say OK now. So the project will be open, and next thing I'm going to say File, Import, and notice we have import capabilities for Altium, P-CAD, CADstar, and other ones. So we're going to pick P-CAD, and now we're going to add where that P-CAD schematic is, and we're going to translate this into the DX Designer. We can also, if you want to, translate just libraries, and also there is a mapping file that you can set up for attributes for being translated over. So we're going to issue a translate command, and it's going to go and translate that, and it is done now. So translation has finished, so now let's review what has translated into DX Designer. Here's our top page for this project, and here is the second page, and I can zoom in. And as you can see, we translated this database over from P-CAD. After translating the schematic, we can now look at the different translations available for the databases. As you can see, we have different tabs from Protel, P-CAD, OrCAD, and CADstar to translate our layouts. So now we're going to translate a P-CAD layout. We're going to add the database we want to translate. So we'll take this project and this P-CAD database, and we're going to place this database inside the same project. We'll pick P-CAD 2, and we'll select this folder that I'm going to put that information where to translate the database. Also, if there's any libraries, we can also translate inside the same database. So under attribute mapping, we can select different attributes to translate. This is default settings that are already picked for us. And for the net attributes, you can also create the mapping to the PADs layout. So we'll say OK now and translate this database. It's going through the process of translating. And as you can see, it doesn't take that long to do it. And it's a fairly straightforward process. There is no error, so we can close this. And Now we will open our PADS layout and we'll open this database to see what kind of translation we got. So we'll go to this PCAD to PADS translation under TR folder. Notice that it took original name of the file and add underscore PADS.PCB into it. So, and now we're opening this database, and as you can see, it's a fully routed board with everything translated inside PADS layout taken from the P-CAD database. So also we can see if there are any translation for the port came over, and we're going to start and notice that even the pouring of the copper were translated inside the PADS. So it is easy to translate a P-CAD database into the PADS layout. From the examples you saw, migrating into PADS from different databases is very easy. You just select the database and you just go and translate it. It saves tremendous amount of time utilizing your existing IP of library development and some designs that you can reuse portions of it. Thank you.